The Parrot AR Drone 2.0 is a four-propeller quadricopter, or, to put it more colloquially, a spinning instrument of death and destruction. You control the drone using an app on your iOS or Android device, though, to be honest, control might be overstating it a bit. We found that flying the drone, especially in a crowded environment like the TechHive offices, could be a bit touch and go.
Bring it back.
The real trick is finding the right way to control the drone, since you can use either a virtual joystick or accelerometer-based controls. Once you've got the hang of it, flying the drone, even in a somewhat narrow hallway, is manageable, though you can never quite sate the drone's unquenchable thirst for human blood. In addition to maneuvering the drone from side to side and front to back, you can also rotate it around a central axis and control its altitude. Just in case you want to drop it on some poor, unsuspecting person's head. Note, TechHive does not endorse dropping the AR Drone 2.0 on your colleague's head, even if they really deserve it.
I'm not going to say I was afraid for my life the whole time, but yeah, for most of the time.
Given the steep learning curve of the device, we were pretty glad for the drone's optional styrofoam indoor safety hull, which provides a nice cushion for when you inevitably bump into walls. Still, our control was imprecise enough that even the safety hull merited a few necessary repairs. Like its previous incarnation, the AR Drone 2.0 sports a pair of onboard video cameras, including a high-definition video camera on the front. When using the drone outside, which we did not attempt on the grounds that our license to fly would probably be revoked, this will probably get some spectacular footage. Inside, though, it's mainly useful for catching your friends' and coworkers' looks of unbridled terror. But, in the end, it was the immortal words of pilot and philosopher Launchpad McQuack that resonated most deeply. Any landing you can walk away from is a good one.